Menifee. This is Doug Spoon with Menifee 24/7, wishing you a happy Monday morning, January 7th. We've got a full week of broadcasts for you this week. Seems like forever since we've had a full work week that wasn't interrupted by holidays. Of course, not that that was a bad thing, but now we got to get back into the swing of things. Unfortunately, Tommy and Kristen were unavailable to join me today, so you're stuck with me going over some today's highlights. Tommy will be back tomorrow talking about one of the most important things that we've been discussing lately, and that's our first annual Menifee Yard Sale Day. Ta-da! Right? Now, this is billed as a community yard sale, but it's not going to be at one particular location. We are going to coordinate the publication of all the yard sales that you have. We are going to publicize those in advance of January 19th, which will be the special day when we hope everyone will be able to go around to all the different sites in Menifee and check out the items that are for sale, maybe make a little money for yourselves, pick up an item or two. We'll talk a little bit tomorrow about some tips for yard sales with Tommy and some of her memories and some of ours about what goes on at these things and how you can unload some stuff that you just don't need anymore. So we want you to stay tuned for tomorrow's show to hear more of that, but put that on your calendar. We've received a great response from a lot of you. Just hang on, and tomorrow we'll have information on how you can register, because we need an official accounting of the people that are committing to do this. So don't tell us that you're going to if you don't. Otherwise, you may have a bunch of people showing up at your doorstep the morning of January 19th, and you won't have anything to sell them. We think it's going to be a great success, and so we look forward to hearing more about that tomorrow. So as we get back to business and talk about some other news in the city, we want to let you know that tomorrow at 5 o'clock is the Menifee Union School District's first board meeting of 2019. They have a new start time. It's been pushed to a half hour later at 5 o'clock at the Bob O'Donnell Center on Hahn Road. No, they will not make a decision tomorrow on who the new Area 5 representative will be on the board. As you know, William Hoag, who won the election, has withdrawn after it was discovered that he was ineligible, and the board's decision has been to consider all four of the remaining candidates, which would be Kenyon Jenkins, Debbie Mannion, Jerry Bowman, who served before in that position, and Joe Long. All of them have been invited to, in the next week, participate in interviews with the current board members, and a decision will be made on who to appoint from among them. Now, Kenyon Jenkins has a slight lead over Debbie Mannion, or had a slight lead for second place in the final results that were posted. Menifee 24/7 has conducted a poll on who you think should be appointed, and by far, Kenyon Jenkins, as the second place finisher to William Hoag, is the reader's choice on that. So we'll see what happens. They actually will have candidate interviews the following Tuesday, the 15th. That's a public meeting that is open to you to go witness as well. And then at their next regular meeting on January 22nd, they are going to decide who will be the next representative in Area 5. So they'll finally be back up to five members. Now, I want to talk a little bit about sports coverage. For those of you who don't know, I'm an old sports writer from way back. I like to tell my stories to my journalism students about back in the 1970s, 80s, 90s, when I used to go on the road with the Dodgers and USC and cover Super Bowls and Olympic Games and World Series and all that fun stuff. So sports has always had a special place in my heart. But of course, as editor of Menifee 24/7, we have a whole gamut of things happening in town to cover. Sports sometimes takes a little bit of a back seat, which is frustrating to me. It's a manpower issue and something that we continue to address, but we are going to continue to invite coaches, scorekeepers, anyone that has information on games that are being played, to send us a private Facebook message, send us an email at info@menifee247.com. We'll monitor on Max Prep's website what's going on with our teams, and we will get out to games whenever possible. A couple of notes that have come into me recently. One is about the Paloma Valley girls soccer team. They have a 7-3 record overall and are 2-0 in league so far. They are in Division III, but most of their games have been played against Division I and II opponents. And in case you don't remember, they won the CIF Southern Section title last year. So they're well stocked again, and they will be at home tomorrow at 5 o'clock against Riverside Poly, and the two of them are very close together in the rankings. So if you have a chance, go on out there and check out the Wildcats. The Wildcats boys basketball team played Saturday against Notre Dame. They lost 74-62, but had some high scores. Demario Willard scored 20 points. Tyler Kessinger had 15, and Richard Zweifach had 14. So Paloma is 12-9 overall and 2-3 in league as league play continues. Meanwhile, the Heritage boys basketball team, they lost to Paris on Saturday 79-54. They still have a winning overall record, 11-7, and they also are 2-3 in league. So we urge you to support these teams, to let us know what's going on, to invite us out to what you think some of the key games are, and we'll listen to you. If you've got highlights of your youth sports, i.e. Little League, soccer, youth basketball that's going on, we want to promote all these things. So let us know. Keep us informed. And while I'm in here solo in the studio today and I don't have Tommy or Kristen to stop me, I'm going to climb up on my soapbox for a minute and talk about the Soapbox Derby, one of my favorite events in town. It used to be held every year, running down the hill on Menifee Road towards Holland, and people would line up and watch kids and sometimes their parents race soapbox racers down the hill. Kind of reminds you of the old Little Rascals movies and just kind of hometown country fun. It wasn't held in 2017, I believe, because of the problems or the competition between the city of Menifee and Valleywide Recreation over control of the parks in the city. Valleywide has always run the event with the cooperation of the city, closing the streets and so forth. It didn't happen that year. I got up on my soapbox before, in print at least, and urged the two parties to come together and bring it back in 2018. It was scheduled for this fall as part of the 10-year anniversary events, and it was rained out that day. And I know that it was disappointing to some of the kids who had put together racers and were ready to partake in the event and bring it back. Since then, there's been no announcement on a rescheduling of that. And I just want to let you know that I'm going to continue to push to bring back an event like that. I think we need more things like that. I don't see why we can't have it this spring. So if you want to join me in that, contact the two entities and let them know, let's get together and get this scheduled, and let's schedule it now for this spring so that we have time to bring more people in, get their kits together, build their racers, and have a good time. All right, so I'm stepping down off my soapbox now and saying that's all for today. Until tomorrow when we talk yard sale again with Tommy, have a good Monday.